parts of Norway in the 17th and 18th centuries, there was a tradition for making double sheaths called tvislire. The knives for these sheaths were of a special kind, with long decorated bolsters. My knives are not a copy of any specific original knives. Therefore, they are inevitably an interpretation of the original style.
This film shows the making of the handles and bolsters. I make the bolsters from bronze plate. The blanks are shaped to make the bolsters concave. Silver is used to solder the bronze. The cap is cut round to fit the bolster. The bolsters are shaped on a wooden dowel. I mark the pencil as I engrave. The engraving is done with a burin. This ornamentation is sometimes found on knives from the 17th and 18th centuries. There will be one bolster in each end of the handles, with holes for the tongues. A heated iron rod is used to straighten the hole. Already, I draw staring lines for the shape. A precise tongue hole is made with a rasp. The tongue must fit the handle perfectly. The handle is formed in several steps. A lot of the shaping is done by eye. Both bolsters and tongue must fit perfectly. One of the handles will have bronze bands between the bolsters. The bands are shaped on a homemade tool, so the ends will fit under the bolsters. Lines are engraved. When the handles are polished, they will be dyed. I use a coloring agent where the pigment is dissolved in alcohol. The handles get a reddish color. The blades are made with a full-length tongue. A button covers the end of the tongue. I rivet the tongue in the traditional way. Pores in the wood are filled with oil.
Now you have seen how the knives were made. Maybe next year I will get around to making the sheaths from leather and wrought iron.